At this time, we're going to receive our praise and worship team.
I can tell the day.
Okay, church, you see the pastor's picture there. You can send him on the option.
Jordan.
Also on the Cash App, $ Solid Rock, AFC. And put a notation in letting you know that it's for morning service.
Yes.
Or you can mail it to Solid Rock Apostolic Church, P.O. Box 358, Randerstown, Maryland, 21133. Or we can receive it in person. We're going to ask if Sister Kimberly, if you can stand over here to my left, your right, and to receive our offering in Jesus' name for those who's coming up to the offering tray. Amen. Amen. Service in the hands of the usher for in-house and back in the hands of our praise and worship team.
Amen. Those who have in-house offering, stand.
Kumbaya, my Lord, kumbaya, kumbaya, my Lord, kumbaya, kumbaya, my Lord, kumbaya, oh Lord, kumbaya, come by here, my Lord, come by here,
that's what it means,
come by here, my Lord, come by here, come by here, my Lord, come by here.
Of glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Worship him. We honor him.
We bless his name. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yeah! Oh, Father. Hallelujah. I'm going to two passages of scripture, the first of which is in the book of Corinthians, chapter 16, verse 8 and 9. After which I'm going to move over to the book of Jeremiah, the second chapter. Amen. First Corinthians, the 16th chapter. Amen. Verses 8 and 9. The Bible said, but I will tarry at Ephesus. This is Paul talking to the Corinthian church. Until for a great door and effectual is opened unto me, and there are many adversaries. Nehemiah, the second chapter, verse 1 to 10. And it came to pass in the month Niacin, in the 12th year of Artaxerxes, the king, that wine was before him, and I took up the wine and gave it unto the king. Now I had not been before time said in his presence. Wherefore the king said unto me, why is thy countenance sad, seeing thou art not sick? This is nothing else but sorrow of heart. Then I was very sore afraid. Said unto the king, let the king live forever. While should not my countenance be sad, when the city, the place of my father's sepulchre, lieth waste, and the gates thereof are consumed with fire? Then the king said unto me, for what doest thou make request? Keep that in mind right there. Then the king said unto me, for what doest thou make request? That's a door. So I prayed to God, the God of heaven, and I said unto the king, if it please the king, and if thy servant have found favor in thy sight, that thou wouldest send me unto Judah, unto the city of my father's sepulchre, that I may build it. And the king said unto me, the queen also sitting by him, for how long shall thy journey be, and when wilt thou return? So it pleased the king to send me, and I set him a time. Moreover, I said unto the king, if it please the king, let letters be given me to the governor beyond the river, that they may convey me over till I come unto Judah. And a letter unto Asaph, the keeper of the king's forest, that he may give me timber to make beams for the gates of the palace, which appertained to the house, and for the wall of the city, and for the house that I shall enter into. And the king granted me according to the good hand of my God upon him. Then I came to the governors beyond the river and gave them the king's letters. Now the king had sent captains of the army and horsemen with me. When Sanballat the Horonite and Tobiah the servant, the Ammonite, heard of it, it grieved them exceedingly that there was come a man to seek the welfare of the children of Israel. 6th chapter, verses 1 to 3. Now it came to pass when Sanballat and Tobiah and Geshem and the Arabian and the rest of our enemies heard that I had builded the wall and that there was no breach left therein, though at that time I had not set up the doors upon the gates. Then Sanballat and Geshem sent unto me, saying, come, let us meet together in some one of the villages in the plain of Ono. But they thought to do me mischief. And I sent messengers unto them, saying, I am doing a good work. so that I cannot come down. Why should the work cease while I leave it and come down to you? I'd like to go back to 1 Corinthians, if you will. 1 Corinthians, the 16th chapter. 1 Corinthians, the 16th chapter, and that verse 9, if you can and will read it with me. For a great door and effectual is open unto me, and there are many adversaries. I'd like to use for a topic on today, go from the door and don't let the opposition stop you. Go through the door and don't let the opposition stop you. I know for this year we're talking about going through the door in 2024. But what I did not tell you on watch night was this. It sounds good. God's going to open up doors, and we're going through the doors, and this is a wonderful thing, and I'm happy all about it, amen. And we've already gone through some. Amen. Anybody gone through any doors already? Hallelujah. Isn't God great? Hallelujah. It's a wonderful thing, amen, to go through the door when God opens the door for you to be able to go through. But what I don't believe I explained to you all was this.
Come on now.
When God opens doors,
Come on. Come on now. Lord have mercy.
It's like Paul says here, for a great door, an effectual, is open unto me.
Yes.
And there are many adversaries.
Christ,
huh? Gotta get it done. I know I would like to get it done without any opposition coming up against me. I would like to get it done without any type of frustration. I would like to get it done. Amen. With a clear court. I would like to get it done with nobody getting on my nerves. I would like to get it done without having to rebuke the devil. But by any means necessary, I'm going to get it done. That's what you got to let the devil know. That's what you got to let the devil know. Now you see here, over in the book of 1 Corinthians, and Paul is talking to the Corinthian church. He's letting them know, I am coming to Corinth, but I'm not coming yet. Because God has opened up, he didn't just say a door, but a great door. See, some of us got great doors that's being opened before us, that God wants us to go in. And honey, the greater the door, the bigger the demon. But that's all right, because God is backing you up. You got everything you need to conquer the demon, to conquer the devil. They're trying to stop you. You won't be able to trample the devil under your feet. You won't be able to tell the devil, get behind me, Satan. Get behind me, but you're not in control. God has given me a destiny and the power to complete the task. Paul said, I'm coming, but I'm not coming yet. The reason why I'm not coming is because a great door has been opened. Amen. Unto me and effectual. In other words, I'm working in this door. Oh, God is saving in this door. God is delivering people in this door. But I got many adversaries. But it ain't going to move me. It's not going to stop me from accomplishing the mission. I'm staying in this door where God placed me. I know the devil don't like it. Oh my God. See, they did Paul somewhat like they did Jesus. Everywhere Jesus would go, the enemy would show up. I mean, they would travel places and show up in the midst. They did that with Paul when he would go from one city to another city. They would hop in whatever transportation and go to the next city so they could harass him, try to turn the people against them. But I come to tell you that if God be for you, who can be against you? What that scripture mean? It doesn't mean that people won't be against you, but what it means is it really don't matter, because greater is the God that is in you than the devil that is in your poor, those that oppose you. So Paul said, I'm going to stay right here. Sometimes you got to let the devil know, no, I'm going to stay right here. I see you acting up, I'm going to stay right here. Oh, I must be doing something good, because it's aggravating you. It's stirring you up. Yes, it is. I'm going to stay right here. You know, I remember Bishop Leslie. Sometimes he would teach Bible class, and he'd get on a part of the message. Amen. And it seemed like it's getting quiet. And Bishop said, no, I'm going to stay right here. He said, I must hit pay dirt. I'm going to stay right here. You got to stay where it is. When you know what God wants you to do. All the Bible says that I'm showing it. Hey, Lord. And when God began to move, God began to show his power. God began See, that is what it's designed to do. It's designed to stop you from accomplishing in that door what God put you in it for. You can always back out and turn around. But I advise you that if God opened the door, then keep on moving, then keep on walking, walk in my faith and not by sight, because you ain't always see your way through. You're not going to always see what the end going to be, what your natural eye. Put on your spiritual glasses and walk in the spirit. Walk in the spirit and block the devil out and do what God has chosen you to do. You can't stop because there are some disturbances that's meant to happen. And sometimes when I kept women, well, maybe God did say for me to do this. Because it seemed like everything broke loose. It seemed like seemed like everything breaking loose, everything going the wrong way, opposition all over the place. It just seemed like I can barely make it through what I'm dealing with. But God said, no, 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 I got you. The devil is just using those tactics. Amen. They scare tactics. They are scare tactics. See, scare tactics are what terrorists use. They use scare tactics. Now, listen. This is going to happen to you if you don't give in to us. And so sometimes people become afraid and they just simply surrender and stop fighting. Where they would have won. But because the terrorists did a scare tactic and they saw what happened to somebody else, many have failed. But that don't mean you have to fail.
My God.
The problem was they took their eyes off of Jesus. See, Peter took his eyes off of Jesus because when he took his eyes off of Jesus, and he saw what was going on, he began to sin. But as long as his eyes stayed on Jesus and he blocked out what was going on, because it was already going on.
Right.
It didn't just get started. When you read in that scripture, it didn't just get started. Right. It was like that when he got out the ship. But he was focused on Jesus at first. His focus was on Jesus. And if it's you, let me do what you doing. Beat me to come unto you on the water. It don't matter how rocky you get. That's not the point. That's not the point. God is calling you somewhere. And the God that's calling you to another place, to another level, to another dimension, is waiting for you to reach your destination. So he is not going to fail you. Because he said, "Lo, I am with you always, even until the end of the world. I am with you. I'm going to see you all the way through, but I did not tell you there will not be opposition." So when you see opposition, just praise the Lord. Just praise the Lord. Tell opposition, "I expected you. I expected you." Because anytime God opens the door, you don't want me to go in. And when I'm in, you don't want me to finish what's inside of the door for my life. You want me to become frantic and run back out of my own blessing. others as well. See, you're not just blessed. You will be blessed to be a blessing. Oh, yeah. So Paul wasn't afraid. He said, I'm going to stay where I am. I'm coming to you later, but I got to stay here. I got to stay in this door. But I want y'all to know that I got many adversaries, but I'm staying in the door. In the midst of my adversaries, I am going to stay in the door. The psalmist said, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He restores my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. Why? Because thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff comfort me. Thou prepare me. He is right here.
Still gonna do it, huh?
Nehemiah found out what was going on back in Jerusalem. The walls were torn down. And there was no gates to the city. Things were burnt up. He was sad in his spirit. Goes before the king to bear the king's wine as he did regularly. And he gets before the king and he has a sad countenance, which you were not supposed to go before the king looking sad. So the king looks at him and says, what's wrong with you? And of course he starts to be afraid because he understands the rule. You don't go before the king with no sad things. But what he did is he began to tell him what was going on. Amen. In his life.
Hallelujah.
Now here I go. Because some of us, we keep expecting that it will be somebody that is saved. Sanctified, Holy Ghost filled, and fire that time. That God is going to use to open the door for us.
My God.
No, sometimes it's going to be a heathen.
That's right.
Well, why would you say that? Because the earth is the Lord's. The fullness thereof, the world, and they that dwell therein. It is God. It can be somebody who don't like you, who hate you.
Come on.
But they will find themselves opening up a door for you need to go in. And once you get in, they will get mad. Go on in there, people looking at you, rolling their eyes, no. I'm not this door that God will go out the door. If God said go out the door. But until God tell me to go out the death door, I'm going to pay him. And I'm going to get the work done. Hallelujah.
Amen.
My God, my God. But our position is coming. It's coming. I mean, don't nobody like it. I don't like our position. I don't like confrontation with the adversary. But we're going to have it. Nehemiah asks for certain things. He asks for lettuce. He asks for timber and things like that to build a wall. He told me he came with the water. Materials and all this. And then I don't have no money like that. But the door God put him in where he had to serve.
Come on now.
Yes, Lord.
He gets his request.
Amen.
he goes on to Jerusalem. And gets to, before he gets there, wait a minute. Before he gets there, the enemy hears that he's coming to do the work. Yes, Sanballat and Tobiah, they hear that he's on the way. They are his adversaries because they want the mission to be accomplished. And he gets there, he surveys, he starts getting messages. See, once you go in the door, the devil starts sending you messages. Because he wants you to run right back out. You better get up, you better leave, child, you better run, but let's go get in a hurry. If you want some out. You might as well go. Bye. Go. It's not going to get accomplished. It's not going to be anything. It's not going to be worth anything what you talk about you're going to do. Talk about you're going to build some walls. If a fox go up on that wall, it's going to fall down. See how the enemy try to discredit you before you even get started. That's really when we should start smiling like, oh, sookie, sookie now. Talking to the people that's working on the wall. Because sometimes it's not just you, but it's people that's working along beside you and with you and whatever God is using you to accomplish in your life. The enemy is trying to scare them so they can stop. But see, you got to encourage those that are around you that's also promoting the will of God. You got to encourage them. Hold on and don't give up. And it got so bad that it was like, okay, it seemed like they're probably going to try to come in on us. See, the Bible said watch and pray. Don't just watch. Amen. And don't just pray. But watch and pray. Because we've been in the last of the days. It's just some things that you have to do that maybe back in the years you didn't have to do. But you can do it now. You understand what I'm saying? When they were in the upper room, Jesus asked. I know this gonna hit some people, and it's probably gonna just knock you out your socks. I can't believe what is in the Bible we're reading. Okay, when they were in the upper room, Jesus asked, "How many swords do we have?" Well, we know Peter had four. And he began to tell them about, you know, how he had set them up before and told not to take this and not take that and not take that. And he said, listen, he said, the time is going to come where you're going to need more than just that sword. Why would you need a sword? Yeah. being done. Peter was trying to save Jesus from going through what he had to go through by cutting that servant's ear off. Yes. But Peter had the sword all the time when he was walking around with Jesus. And you never heard Jesus say, Peter, take that sword off. I'm going to get that sword. I'm not asking. I'm telling you the Bible says it's in the book. I'm not telling you nothing that's not in the book. It was wrong.
Glory.
You got to set some things in place sometimes that maybe you didn't have to set in place years ago because the world is getting worse. It's getting worse. Now that was a little sidebar.
I got it too. What's happened?
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Lord.
So,
Nehemiah hears the threat. Thank you. So he understands, I'm in the door now. I'm in the door. I'm in the door. And we're working. We're doing what God would have us to do. We're building. When you get to building, you're building something. You're building something. You're building and you're working hard at it. And those that are with you are working hard at getting it done. Amen. And here comes the adversary, the opposition. Amen. That wants you to stop. Don't want it finished. Don't want it accomplished. Down it before it's already done. You ought to know it ain't nobody but the devil. The devil's getting upset. He's trying to distract my attention. But I'm going to be ready for you, dog. I'm going to be ready for you, dog. I'm not going to just ignore what you're saying because I'm going to watch and pray. I'm going to listen to what you're saying because I need to prepare. You understand? For your attack. You got to prepare to be attacked by the devil. You got to prepare. That's why we got to fast. That's why we got to pray. You understand? That's why we got to stay in our word. That's why we got to stay full of the Holy Ghost. Whew. I say, fool. We on the wall and we build, but now you're threatening us. You're threatening us. Okay. So I'm gonna take you up on what you're saying. I'm gonna trust you that you just might try to come in and try to do some damage. But if you try to come and do some damage, we're gonna be ready for you. You know, we're gonna be ready. So that's what Nehemiah's mindset was. We're gonna be ready, but we're gonna keep on working. We're gonna stay in this door, we're gonna keep on working, we're gonna keep doing what we need to do. You're not gonna stop us now. We ain't gonna stop. But what we are gonna do is we're gonna arm ourselves like we need to arm ourselves just in case you attack. And then he let them know what to do in each quadrant. He said, listen here, alright, what you're going to do is you're going to go to sleep. You're going to sleep for some hours, alright, and they're going to be working, okay? You sleep while we work, alright? And then we work and you sleep. But what we're going to do is we're going to have a weapon on one side and we're going to get the job done with the other side. Oh, sometimes you gotta work with both hands. You understand what I'm saying? You gotta. Yeah! And I'm over here.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm building for the Lord.
Come on,
I'm building His work. I'm getting the work of God done. Yeah! I'm getting His work. Working with God, Jesus. I see you working it out, Lord. I see how you're moving, Lord. I see you, Jesus. He go to the devil in your house. He go to the liar.
Come on now.
What? I gotta do what I gotta do. Yeah. Come on your job, devil. You a liar. The blood of Jesus is against you. Come on, let me get this done. I gotta do what I gotta do. I'm getting the work done. I'm gonna keep on getting it done. And the devil popping up, and you gotta attack the devil when he attack you. And you gotta get back to your work. You gotta do the work, do the work, do the work. Cause I'm staying in the door. You ain't getting me to stop.
That's right.
You're not getting me to stop. So they kept building, kept building, kept building, kept building. They were lying and doing all that. They lied on and all that stuff. Oh, you trying to be a king. You trying to do this. You trying to do that. You know what you trying to do. Say you as a liar. I'm going to keep on building.
people lying on you, saying all kinds of stuff. Oh, you're trying to do this, you're trying to do that. As long as you know you ain't trying to do the wrong thing, you keep on doing what you're supposed to do. You keep on doing what you're supposed to do and let God move like God wants to move. You keep doing what you're supposed to do. Now they got a whole lot of the wall built, and they heard that it was built. They got to go to the leader, because you got to get the leader. If you get the leader to stop, then everything will go down, right? So they said, listen, Nehemiah, this. What we want you to do is come down here and meet us in the valley, around the valley of Ono. So we can talk about what's going on. What's being said about you. Wow. Nehemiah said, we are about a good work. This open door, why should I come down to talk to you? You gotta let the devil know that small stuff. All that little bit of stuff that you're trying to get started, that's small stuff. Yeah. Yeah. But you know how people, did you hear what they said about you? They said such and such. They did. Maybe the Lord help me. I'm about God's business. You don't know how something about something, okay? It's all good. You got to expect anything to happen when you're about the Father's business. They talk about Jesus. Who are they? They talk about Jesus. Tree, and I am the dry tree. I'm not better than my Lord and my Savior. So let them talk. Some people want you to get all mad. What? Now, I know that they talk about me. I don't know who they think they are talking about me. Wait till I get on Facebook. Wait till I get on Instagram. Wait till I go on Twitter. X. I got something to say to them.
Don't say it.
Oh, let these fingers do the talking. So you're wasting precious time that you're supposed to be using in the door that God has opened up for you. And you coming down to their level. Listen, God has taken you to another level.
Come on now.
Why would you digress?
Come on now.
And go down there?
Come on.
Why would you do that?
God Almighty.
Let them stay where they like.
Come on. Yeah.
They want to be talking about people arguing and fussing and doing all that crazy stuff, conjuring up stuff.
That's right.
Whatever. Let them do what they want to do.
Right.
You're not there.
That's right.
You're not on that level.
That's right.
You don't want to be on that level. You want to go as high as God wants to take you. So let them do whatever. I was listening to someone before, and they were talking, and they were kind of talking about the giraffe. Sometimes, you know, God may have you in a place where you're a giraffe.
Right. Yep.
You know, the giraffe has a long neck, and the giraffe is tall. Am I right?
Yes, ma'am.
Right. And sometimes, look, what would it look like if a little ant was caught around trying to start an argument with a giraffe? How far down did the giraffe have to come to deal with that ant? Like, really? Why are you entertaining this stuff? Why are you entertaining that stuff? It's not worth it. God is saying you're on a different level. And I'm not talking about for pride stuff. That's not what I'm talking about. But when God puts you on another level spiritually, they wanted confusion. But Nehemiah refused to give them what they wanted. He stayed in the door and they finished the mission earlier, sooner than what they were expecting to finish it. See, if you just do it like God tell you to do, God can move that thing so fast. Your life can speed up so quick. The years that the locust, the cankerworm, the palmerworm, the caterpillar had eaten up, and it felt like, oh my God, I'm way behind. God has sped you up so fast. You are ahead of people that started before you. You understand what I'm saying? Don't tell me what God won't do in your life when he opens a door for you to go through. Don't tell me what he won't do. Because God will do it. But when he does it, make sure you finish what you're supposed to finish. And that you don't allow the opposition to stop. Alright? Go to that door, stay in that door, and refuse to let whatever the devil throws your way, because he's going to break it, make you leave out of that door. Get all the blessing that you're supposed to get. Get it. I got to tell you, because as our elder told us on Watch Night as well. Amen. The good, the bad comes with the good. And this is true. The bad comes with the good. Even Jesus said that if you have given up houses and land and all of the fathers and mothers, he said, I'm going to give it to you right here, 100-fold. I'm going to bless you with that. But he takes up on the end of that scripture. How many people want houses and money? Oh, some of y'all just don't want it. Hallelujah! I want houses and land. Hallelujah! I know heaven is my home, but I made it. And I don't just want it so that I can just have it all to myself. That's not why I want stuff. That's not why I want stuff. Because you can only do it for so much. Then you just start doing foolish stuff. Unless you are giving and helping others with what you have. So I had some people that want houses and land. Some of y'all was probably scared. That's why you get ready to learn, because you don't know what's coming. So some of us might get some of your stuff. I'm sorry. As Jesus said, that it is going to be given to you right here on this earth. Okay, most of us is really all right. Thanks. Whatever you have to do, of course. All right. Suffer your sins. That goes by faith. But at the end of the scripture, it says, when persecution, I'm going to give it to you, but it's going to come with persecution. Do you not know that everybody is not happy for you?
Come on now.
Everybody's not happy when you stand up. He blessed me and he opened the door. I didn't know where the money was going to come from. But he gave me my own house. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You got some people sitting back looking. Like, she don't even know her. I've been waiting for a house all these years. Now, don't let nobody be married. Go to God in heaven. I've seen this kind of stuff with my own.
Come on now.
Person get married, they happy, and then you got somebody treating the person bad. I've seen it with my own eyes. But Jesus, why'd you get mad at the person?
Come on.
Listen. And God will bless you. God will bless you. But your problem is, you don't want nobody to be blessed unless it's you.
Come on
down. Oh, I can say something.
Come on, sir.
You don't want nobody to be blessed unless it's you. Some people are like that. They don't want nobody to be blessed except themselves. Anybody else get blessed, they will not rejoice with them. They got a sour face, a sour face. But let them get a blessing. They want to raise the whole roof off the building. They want to make the whole church jump up and start shouting. Oh, ain't nobody kidding with me. Come on and bless God with me. Come on.
Your head is pounding.
Your eyeballs is So when you connect it, you gotta be excited for somebody else's door. Or doors. I don't care how many doors God opened for them. You ought to be happy and you ought to be excited. And don't let it be predicated on how many doors are open for you. It is not about that.
That's right.
Because if he blessed you, he blessed me. That's how you got to see. If God doesn't say he blessed me, I'm blessed when faith blessed. Because she's part of me. That's why I can shout and I can dance. Just as if it was me. Oh my. I'm about to. And it's the same thing when it comes down to pain. When you really get connected. When you get connected. And some people are deeper into that, are deeper with that than others, that they really like, feel pain. Other pain, just like they can. They can feel it. Sometimes you gotta feel somebody else's pain.
Come on now.
So you can be more empathetic. And have more sympathy. Be more caring for somebody else. Because that's the will of God. Don't let the devil stop you. Jesus didn't let the devil stop him. He went through the door, and yes, he had a whole lot of opposition. If Jesus did not stay in his door, where would we be today? I want y'all to think about that. If Jesus did not stay in the door that he was supposed to go through, and it was a door of adversity, it was a door of bitterness, there was a cup that needed to be drank. But it was the benefit of the whole human race. And you better know the devil was talking. And it wasn't like he was like anxious. Oh yeah, let me go to this door. I'm happy to go to this door. No, he struggled. He struggled to go through. Easy for Joseph. The doors that were open for Joseph didn't always seem like nice doors. But they were the doors that he needed to go through to get to. Oh, see, you've been through some doors already. You got some hard knocks and all of that. Disappointments, shedding tears, had heartaches, had pains. But it's going to take you to a good place. It's taking you to a good place. You needed those doors for where God's taking you. Woo. Those doors gave you testimonies for the SOB. Those doors gave you depth, deepness. Those doors gave you wisdom, gave you knowledge, gave you understanding. So you will know what you're talking about when you open your mouth to loose captives and let the oppressed go free. You gon' know. But you had to go through the book.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
But trust you me. All doors are not just filled with pain and heartache. Oh no, God's got happiness and God's got joy. Oh, God got great experiences for your life. Do you hear about that? Before you get up out of here. Oh, it's going to be better. Before you get up out of here. So don't just think that all God has for you is some suffering. Oh, we know that suffering is going to come. But there's going to be a whole lot of goodness, honey, that's coming to you. A whole, God ain't going to let you suffer the way you've been suffering and not going to reward you greatly. I'm going to say it again, greatly, for your suffering. We don't serve a God like that. I mean, he's a rewarder, but he's a good reward when he rewards. So your blessing is at hand. It's at hand. This is the altar call. You're here today. God's opening up the door for you, and the door has already been opened, the door of salvation. All you have to do is come and receive from the Lord. The door of salvation is open. If you want to be saved, God wants to save you. Jesus died so that you could be saved. He went through the door of pain and shame and agony so that you could be saved. That's what Jesus did for you and for me. I answered the call when he said, come to me. Oh, you that live in a heavy laden. I will give you rest. I'm so glad I came. I cannot explain to you how glad I am that I came. I cannot explain. I'm so glad that he allowed me to enter into that door of salvation, and I'm still in that door today. And you can have it too. That door is open. You can come and you can receive it. Hallelujah. Let God fill you with that tongue talking Holy Ghost. Let Him pour His Spirit in you. Let Him save you. Let Him redeem you. Let Him deliver you. Let Him bring you out. Let Him rescue you. Whatever it is that you need him to do, let God do it. I'm telling you, God is able. He's able. Hallelujah. The door is open. Go through it. And don't let the distractions stop you. Lord, lift me up and let me stand. My faith on heaven's stable land. No higher place than I have found. Lord, place my feet on higher ground. gonna go deeper and deeper. Amen. And God's gonna open the door for you to go higher and higher. He's gonna open the door for you to go deeper and deeper in the Lord, in the Lord, in the Lord, in the Lord. Amen. We appreciate each and every one of you. We want you to know, amen, that we love you, but God loves you best, and we want you to be blessed of the Lord.